Ah, thank you and welcome back in joining us live from the African Space Room. 100 years ago today, the populace of the most arable continent and its descendants across the diaspora catalyzed initiatives to further affirm the Pan-African dream into reality, which can be accredited to the pioneer movement of W.E.B. Du Bois. In this era, without further ado, in its self-acclaimed glory of glaring futures of an African renaissance, are my correspondents live from Earth in the sectors of fashion, economy, education, sports, and politics. My name as your host is Jabachi Namdi Obafemi Nwogu, wishing you a prosperous and joyous day as Africans of the soil and blood.
Ryan Coogler said that Afrofuturism finds a way to bridge the cultural aspects of the ancient African tradition with the potential of the future. Familiar to some, exotic to others, this term in fashion refers loosely to an unlikely fusion of different African styles. Here we are, 100 years later, to finally celebrate the success of African clothing taking the business fashion industry by storm. Our celebration is about the African fashion reborn that happened in the last 100 years. Today, we are giving the award of the best fashion business to AfriPow, a clothing brand inspired by the urban environment of African cities in countries such as Nigeria, Angola, Egypt, and Morocco. Their mission is to raise awareness about the African culture in the business world.
I am Khalifa Fumba Esdole, CEO and board member of African Development Bank. I'm live from Morocco, Liberia, giving the status of industrial development in Africa. Africa is now the world's largest economy, stimulating other continents' economic growth by not just supplying raw materials that is used to sell for ridiculously low prices and repurchased at exorbitant prices. Africa is now the only continent whose economic growth and development is ceaseless after the Delta COVID-19 that left the rest of the world economy in disarray. The fact that the world has reached the United Nations Sustainable Development Goal by reducing extreme poverty is largely driven by Africa economic growth, which accounts for more than 3/4 of the world poverty reduction between 2020 and 2035. Africa is the world's largest manufacturing hub, contributing 50% of global exports. Africa technology has become so powerful that it is indistinguishable from magic. Our currency has emerged as the top number one global currency called ASO. According to a joint continental research report, 78% of global reserve is in Africa, and Africa is the largest provider of foreign direct investment. In a nutshell, Africa economic growth has underpinned global economic convergence and reduced inequality in the world.
I agree to now. Good afternoon. My name is Olu Bebechukwu Bikim, and I come to you live from Johannesburg, South Africa. I present to you the current happenings for the sports sector. The Senegalese boys and girls joint team, they jubilate and celebrate as they don't win their first win after so many years for the Football World Cup competition. We finish on the April 15, 2120. This win where they win, they follow up other past wins where other African countries don't they win for the past, such as Nigeria, Algeria, Kenya and Mauritius. For one interview where we get with them, where we ask them what they think they help them win, they talk say the fact say other African countries don't they win, give them motivation, now make them push harder, say make they won't continue for that part of winning, now help them win. They also talk to, they want to thank the government and other African countries. They want to thank the Senegalese government and other African countries for the support we don't they give them. As if, as they talk, say the Senegalese government don't they put more money for the sports sector, and as they receive better training than they don't they receive before. Now it help them win this win. They, in addition, they also talk say the government don't they pay them, don't they pay them well well, as they receive plenty money and they don't want make the money where they receive go to waste. So they won't make the government and their nation proud as a whole. As they won't conclude, they talk say they go do anything where they for their power to ensure say young pikins out there where shall be play football well well but no get the opportunity, go receive the same opportunity where they get to help them become big football players in the future. Up next, he get plenty teams where they prepare for the World 3-6 competition, where be the first African game when they go they play for the whole wide world. The first team comprised of plenty different African participants where go represent the African continent for the World Intercontinental 3-6 competition. Then he get plenty other national teams where go represent their countries in the World Cup competition. With all the effort where we don't put, with all the hard work and effort where we don't put to ensure say 3-6 now become a global game, we fit only expect a win.
Mamadou Diouf Diallo ngén di am fofu nonu ci sen portal té yalla dogal na ci dogal mi magi ñu tambali topic bu ñu wowe education soko déggé d'abord par
live from Dakar. Senegal is Mamadou Diallo with a report on the state of education on the African continent in the year 2120. Africa continues to bask in the glory of educational revival, having introduced system to allow for the introduction of local dialect as languages of instruction at institution of learning. As students are able to understand concepts in class better, performance in tests and examination has drastically improved. This move has enabled learners at all dialectic backgrounds to access quality education at all levels of institutional learning, allowing more scholars to attain higher levels of education. This, in turn, has caused an overall increment in employment rates at all over the continent and has improved the standards of living for many. This has inspired many learners from other continent to pursue higher education in Africa, and has seen institutions just as Assisi University in Ghana and the University of Nairobi rise in global ranking to become top 10 university rankers. Let us continue to push for our children to access education, and let us not take for granted the journey that has been to achieve this level of development progress.